So whenever I have new people on my boat, I always do a quick orientation. I show everyone where things are, how things work, what to do, what not to do. Of course, while I'm explaining this, I'm sure all they're thinking about is getting away from the dock and hoisting the sails, and what are we going to cook on the barbecue. So what I do is I make up a binder. This one is specifically for a race that I did, the 2013 Southern Straits. And I'm going to just show you some really simple things to do, because if there's an emergency and you need someone to get something, there has to be some sort of reference on your boat that they can look at and quickly go find that item. So here's a closer look at the binder, and I just threw a sheet on the front and I've titled it at the top so it's an easy binder to grab if I do this race again. I can just update some information in there, and I've already got the binder made. I don't keep these binders on the boat because it's limited space here, so I would just, for a race specific binder, I would just leave it in my locker. So we'll open it up. What I've got on the left here is just some loose papers that were given to me for the race. It's got which frequency to use, who to call, how to do it, where it talks about where your start line and finish line is, and who to call. You have to, in this race, you had to check in at each rounding, so you had to check in the time that you rounded it, and you'd call either by VHF or cell phone. This race took us almost 24 hours to finish, so it was an overnight race. So there's just some loose things that, pieces of information. Here's a list of all the boats that have entered, schedule of events, and just some other stuff that was given to me. Oh, this actually, I had this printed off. I typed it out, and it was stuff that we did at a sort of a pre-race meeting with myself and the crew. So let's move this over a little bit. So what I've got is just basically this sort of like a title page, kind of the layouts of the boat. Now what I've done here is, using Photoshop, I've broken all the gear in the boat, or all the items, into three categories. Safety and utilities. So all I do is just a little overlay and an arrow pointing to what it is. Like, there's the battery switch, the fire extinguisher, buoyant heaving line, charts, VHF radio, so anything related to safety or utilities. My next page is kit and supplies and gear, so just anything from pots and pans to garbage bags to cold weather gear, where the jib is, water bottles, things like that. And then the third page is operating systems. So this could be anything from like the propane solenoid to the bilge pump, pressurized water, VHF radio, stereo, anything related to operating systems. So it was super easy to do. I just scanned the original plan drawing of my boat, and then I just do these little tiny overlays in Photoshop, and it makes it really easy. So if you say you need something, I know it, the list very well, so I could say I need something, it'll be on the green highlighted page, so with all the green highlights, and they can look and find it right away. For racing, you'll always have a crew list. Your PHRF rating has to be in there and submitted. I'll have a copy of my insurance in there, my pleasure craft license for the boat, just some other training things that I've got, my radio license. Then we'll have the sailing instructions. So this is specifically for this race. There's quite a few pages there. Here's the course. This is all stuff that's provided by the host club. that is putting on the race. Here's the notice of race and all that information. And for this race, for the PIYA, we had to have a Category 2, I believe it was, or 3. But so I had to have to have a signed copy of that in my boat as well. And just some receipts. In this boat, in this race, we had to have emergency steering system. So what I did was I set it all up and took photos of it, so that when we were inspected at the end of the race, they could just easily look at the photos and see, because obviously we didn't have this set up. We never needed it, but you have to set it up and try it. So just a bunch of photos so that the inspectors could see that, yes, we do actually have a system that can steer the boat in an emergency. On top of that, I just did a little video just showing that the system worked as well. They never asked to see that, but I did have that just in case. And that was just filmed on my iPhone. So there you go. That's sort of what some of the things I do for prepping for a race. And you could make a little book like this that just stays on your boat and has those nice little overlays. Really easy to do for when you have new people on the boat.